This is one of the most important parables in the Gospels, the parable of the sower, which is the Gospel reading from this morning. It appears in all three synoptic Gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and Jesus not only narrates the parable, but he does something rare. He explains it. Why is this parable of the sower so important? Because it's about the Word of God and how we receive it. A seed is sown. The sower sows a seed that scatters far and wide and falls on various places, both on good soil and on bad. The seed is the Word of God. And the same Word of God is offered to everyone. But how much fruit it will bear depends on the condition of our heart and how receptive we are to receiving the Word of God. That's what each of the four soils represents in the parable. The first soil is the path. These are roadways that crisscross the fields. The seed falls on the path, and then the birds swoop in and they eat the seed. This soil represents those who are indifferent to the Word of God. We may be coming to church regularly. We hear the same message as everybody else. But because we are totally disinterested in the Word of God and the things of the kingdom, the devil comes and snatches the Word away from our hearts. Jesus says, be careful how you hear. Be careful how you hear. It's not enough, brothers and sisters, to just hear the Word like some noise in the background, like the vacuum cleaner that's going on in the next room. We have to listen effectively to the Word of God. And with God's grace, we have to try to understand it. Otherwise, we run the risk of becoming hardened to the Word of God. We run the risk of becoming hardened to the Word of God. It's like throwing something against the wall and nothing sticks. It just boom, falls on the ground. The second soil is the rocky ground. This is where there's some shallow soil, so there's some growth, but because just beneath the surface there's this hard rocky layer, the roots are unable to grow deep enough to penetrate to the moisture. This soil represents those who are impulsive. We receive the Word of God with great joy and excitement, but because there's no depth, when a time of testing comes, we fall away. Lots of people get excited, brothers and sisters, and that's a wonderful thing. But what's needed in the Christian life is perseverance and discipline. Think about all the things that are important to you in life. They all demand a certain amount of rigor. I cannot say, you know what, I'm going to go to work when I feel like. Or I don't say, you know what, today I think I'm going to be a good husband. I think today I'm going to be a good wife. No, we know that to be successful at the things that matter in life, we have to work at them each and every day. Yes, there are good days and there are bad days, but we don't just give up. Why is it that we give up so easily when it comes to trying to understand the Word of God? Is it because, and let's be honest, it's just not that important to us compared to everything else I've got going on in my life? It's just not that important. And that takes us to the third soil, which are the thorns. This is where the good crop is growing at the same time as the weeds. But because the weeds grow faster, they choke the good crop. This soil represents those who are preoccupied with life. Those who are preoccupied with life. We can be so focused on life, our families, our friends, our jobs, our wealth, our health, our entertainment, and so on, that it completely drowns out what God is trying to say to us. We put God in a position where he has to compete with so many other things for our attention and for our affection. In fact, we even use them as an excuse. I know I need to be more engaged, but I just don't have the time. I'm too busy. Once I was teaching at the Gather evening session, and I was saying that there's no excuse to miss Mass on Sunday. And one gentleman came and met me after the session and said, "Thank you for saying that. For 2 years, I've used my young children as an excuse why I can't be in church. But that's not going to happen anymore." And a few weeks later, he came, he was in the section where I was distributing communion, and I was happy to see him in church. We use these as excuses. I know I have to be more engaged, but I'm just too busy. I don't have the time. Brothers and sisters, God wants to do so much more with us. Do not let his plan for your life be choked by your preoccupation with this life. Do not let God's plan for your life be choked by your preoccupation with this life. The fourth and last soil is, of course, the good soil. This is actually the only soil that bears fruit and represents those who receive the word of God, retain it, and by persevering, produce a good crop. Brothers and sisters, God wants everyone to be saved and come to a knowledge of the truth. That's 1 Timothy 2:4. This is why God makes the same word accessible to all. Those who will receive it well and those who will reject it. God knows that there are going to be different responses to his word. This is why Jesus frequently spoke in parables, in riddles, to separate those who are earnestly seeking the kingdom of heaven from those who are just casual hearers or superficially interested. Brothers and sisters, are we sincerely seeking the kingdom of heaven? Or are we just a casual hearer or someone who's superficially interested? The good news is that all soils can be the good soil. In our first reading from Isaiah, the Lord says, "My word that goes forth from my mouth shall not return to me empty, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. My word that goes forth from my mouth shall not return to me empty, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it." God's word will always achieve his purposes. Always achieve his purposes. But we still have to cooperate with the Holy Spirit. We still have to make the effort to want to know and understand the Word of God. Now, ultimately, the Word of God is more than just the written or spoken Word. It is the person of Jesus Christ. Jesus is the Word. John, in his Gospel in the first chapter, says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us." In the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Now, John did not say, "In the beginning was the podcast, and the podcast became flesh and dwelt among us." Or, "In the beginning was the blog, and the blog became flesh and dwelt among us." Or, "In the beginning was the video series, and the video series became flesh and dwelt among us." Or, "In the beginning was this ministry, or that meeting, or this devotion, or this spiritual practice, and it became flesh and dwelt among us. Brothers and sisters, these are all wonderful, beautiful things, but they can never be a substitute for the Word of God. Never be a substitute for the Word of God. If you truly want to know Jesus, the incarnate Word of God, we have to become familiar with Scripture, the written Word of God. In fact, St. Jerome goes so far as to say that ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ. Ignorance of Scripture is ignorance of Christ. Now, brothers and sisters, I'm not a very disciplined person. You probably figured that out by now, right? I'm not a very disciplined person. But since I gave my life to the Lord as a teenager, what has helped me the most, what has worked the best, is to be in Bible study, because that has helped me to be disciplined. I've done like 40 years of Bible study. I would encourage you to join one of the Bible studies we have in this parish. I would encourage you. Commit to it, just like you commit to everything else in your personal life. Commit to it. Commit to it. Okay? But please, please do something. I don't want you to leave here and just say, oh, I need to do something about the Word of God, and then you forget by the time you hit the doors. Commit to doing something. Please do something. Become the good soil that God wants you to be. And let the Word of God transform your life so that through you, many more lives will be blessed. Become the good soil that God wants each one of us to be. And let the Word of God transform your life so that through you, many more lives will be blessed. Amen.